Hello friends, in the series of BSc IPF, I welcome you all. We are talking about the economic survey. We have discussed and understood about the basic terminology of the government finances, that what does it mean when we say that capital expenditure, what does revenue expenditure means, what does revenue receipts, capital receipts means, what does fiscal deficit means. So we have discussed it in our previous session, and there is a separate playlist on our YouTube channel about the economic survey. So the investor who wants to understand and know the economic survey in detail can check out the YouTube channel. For there is a separate playlist on our channel. We have discussed about the terminology, but in this session we will try to see the reality of the government finances, where it is standing. Because once the investor is able to understand all these basic things, then only he'll be able to make the right decision in a right direction. And that is what the initiative and the agenda of the BSc IPF and SEBI. They took this initiative. They brought all these sessions only for the small investor and the common man. So don't forget to say them thanks after this session, because they took this initiative. Let us try to see about the government finances. We have discussed about the terminology, and when we visit the or when we see the economic survey, the very first line says that the fiscal deficit overshoot of 1.3%. Fiscal deficit means this is the fiscal deficit, the amount which government will borrow. If it has increased, then either income is lesser or the expenses are more. Let us try to see what have happened. It have happened 1.3%. Estimated gross tax revenues were brought down by 4.5 lakh crores. Means like tax revenue have come down by 4.5 lakh crore. In direct taxes, they have declined by 7.7%, where with comparison of the earlier year, where they have increased by 13%. So here is a huge gap. Instead of increment, there is a decrement. Then, whereas the indirect taxes growth decelerated to 1.7% from 2.9% year ago. So this is also lesser. Number 4.5 lakh rupees is less income to the government. How they have adjusted, whatever the surplus which RBI was having, they have transferred that money. Also, they have asked for the whatever balance was there with the mobile companies for the spectrum, they have asked for it. So non-tax revenue, they have asked for it. What government is expecting in 2021? They are expecting, here we can see that they will follow the FRBM. It is a fiscal responsibilities budgetary management which I have introduced in the early years of 21st century, where they will say that fiscal deficit, primary deficit, revenue deficit will come at the numbers of fiscal deficit to GDP, the ratio will come down slowly year by year. So in 2021 they are expecting non-tax revenue led by spectrum auction, and they are expecting this amount. Also they are expecting by non-debt capital receipt, which is this, by divestment, because fiscal deficit is a debt capital receipt and divestment is a non-debt capital receipt. So they are expecting 2.1 lakh crore, which is four times of what they have realized earlier. So this is what they have done. This is the FRBM Act. We are stopping here right now, but we will come up with the next part of it. Thank you very much for liking our session. You need to write your name along with the email address in the comment section, because that will make us possible to bring all the sessions to you. Also, the same topic is there in Marathi and Hindi. You can check out the YouTube channel for that. Thank you very much for liking our session one more time, and stay tuned. Take care.